Okay, so this shows the posterior aspect of the anterior abdominal wall. This region is the back of the umbilicus, and below it we can see that there are three thickenings. There are two pairs of thickenings and one in the midline. The midline thickening is called the median umbilical fold, and then on its lateral sides there are the medial umbilical folds. Further laterally are the lateral umbilical folds. Actually, the lateral umbilical folds, they do not reach the umbilicus, but they are called lateral umbilical folds. And I think that you can see through the peritoneum here that these folds are occupied by vessels.
These are inferior epigastric vessels, artery and vein.
They branch from the artery is a branch of the external iliac artery just before it passes beneath the inguinal ligament. And the artery ascends up and enters into the rectus sheath. This is the rectus sheath opened from behind, and the artery passes behind the rectus abdominis muscle. The median umbilical fold, which passes through the umbilicus, is the remnant of the uracus. And the two medial umbilical folds, and they are the remnant of the umbilical artery. The umbilical artery brings the blood from the fetus to the mother. It's a deoxygenated blood. Now, above the umbilicus, in the region of above the umbilicus, there is another fold here. You can see we can follow this fold. It is located in the free lower border of the falciform ligament. This is the falciform ligament. The falciform ligament here, which is attached to the liver. And in the free lower border of the falciform ligament is a rounded thickening, a ligamentum teres, which means round, ligamentum teres hepatis, because it is destined for the liver. And this represents the left umbilical vein, obliterated left umbilical vein that carries the oxygenated blood from the umbilicus, from the mother, to the fetus. So all in all, we have six folds, one above the umbilicus, ligamentum teres hepatis, and five folds below the umbilicus, median umbilical fold, two medial umbilical folds, and two lateral umbilical folds, which are vascular, and although they are called umbilical, but they do not reach the umbilicus.